is always good.
Yeah. So how early on in that one? Always seems to like that. So how early in the season did you find out that Guardian was going to be out, and how does that? Well, how excited are you to kind of explore that storyline in season 4? Because we haven't had a lot of heroes in the era that's come out publicly.
Good question. Wait, that was a 3-part question?
Kind of.
All right, so how did I feel about it? What's going to happen? And that was it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. How I felt about it was amazing because it was only dealing with unmasking, but it was dealing with how people feel about the cultural dynamic of being African American, right? So it's almost like we got to put racism where it belongs in the cultural context of bullying. So it's the same thing as a kid, you know, talking about this person's weight. It's the same thing as this kid talking about this person's sexuality. It's something that this person never chose and they can't help, but yet it's still, just because it's the status quo, we're supposed to deal with it. That's not right. So sexism and racism belong in the cultural context of bullying. So I was really happy that we got to do that. And in fact, let's be real about it, most black superheroes wear masks. Everybody here comic book fans?
Yeah.
All right, so can anybody name one black superhero that doesn't wear a mask? Uh-oh.
I mean, John Stewart in a way.
Where's his movie?
I mean, 2020. Where's
his movie?
Where's his what?
Where's his movie?
Wow.
It's 2018.
Luke Cage.
I'm just saying, as of right, Luke Cage.
Luke Cage.
No, we got one.
We got one.
Yeah. Anybody else?
Yeah.
No.
I got Luke Cage.
Thank you. That's a part. It's not a movie yet. It's not live action yet. So I'm just saying. So I think that we also in the writers' room, sort of that came to our attention as well, and we're like, wait a second, that's not cool. Like, wait, we take these black actors and we throw a piece of iron over their face, or you know, some sort of technology over their face, and that's not really the point. Like, if when I was growing up, I didn't have anybody who looked like me to look up to, right? And now when I go to these comic cons, I go to the grocery store, I see a young black kid, 5-6 years old, and he's just like, Mr. Olsen? I'm like, it's not my name, idiot. But, no. It's Brooks. I'm really happy that we're actually tackling those issues. It's going to be real. Yeah.
Where would you like to see James go as a hero this season?
Mars. Love Mars. Oh, you mean like, yeah. I just mean art. I know where he's going, and I like where he's going. And let's just say that because of the unmasking, there's some fallout that happens, and some support, some unexpected support that happens, because he's human, and he's doing something that normally aliens do. Or mutants do, genetically advanced humans do, right? So he happens to be this human being who's just taking his life into his hands, being brave and heroic, and some people appreciate that, and then some other people don't. So there's we start to get it becomes really adhesive to the cultural velocity that we're having right now, where things are happening. God, what can I say?
Like, does everything change?
I can't say anything.
No?
Yeah. Sorry, they just briefed me what I could say. Like, I almost told y'all, like, a huge spoiler.
We wouldn't have told anybody.
Yeah.
He's like, come on,
this is a prop.
Oh, it's a prop, okay.
This is defamation.
What you were saying a minute ago about the heroes to look up to when you were growing up and stuff, does a film like Black Panther make a difference?
I think it does. I mean, like, it made a difference to me. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure it makes a difference to a lot of kids around the world. And it is a movie for kids, right? So I think it definitely made a difference in that realm. For me, it made a difference in the fact that, like, you know, we had a majority black cast lead a $16 billion film. I don't know what it is. And I think that myth that we don't sell overseas is has been shattered. It's been absolutely shattered. And whether or not, you know, that story focuses on Africans or African Americans, I don't think it matters. I think people are saying that hue of human does not sell in Germany. That hue of human does not sell in China. You're wrong. Absolutely wrong. And so some of that is Hollywood manifesting itself into its result, right? So, like, if you don't make the movie, people can't go see it. Like, I didn't notice the people were black in the movie. I was like, this is a good movie. And I was like, oh, yeah, they're black. Like, that happened after. Like, and I think you were probably like, oh, this is a good movie. And then someone was like, oh, you're only black, right? You're like, I don't care, it's a good movie.
So, well, I didn't notice because they brought the one white guy in.
And then yeah, you're like, no. You're like, there's normally more of them.
Something's odd here.
Like, I feel so threatened.
Black guy, it's a black guy.
Listen, and here's my thing about that. I don't think it should be any tokens. Look around this room. There's every shade of every person here. And I don't have one white friend. I don't have one Asian friend. I have a bunch of different types of friends. And I grew up in a place where it was very multicultural. And this country was built on multiple diasporas. So we don't have, you know, I love friends to sit down, but they're not friends of mine because they didn't have any black friends. So what I'm saying is, yes, we can make movies that are all African American if we want to. We can make movies that are all white if we want to. But why not just make the shit look like America? Make it look like the demographics that we actually have already and that are coming. And I think that if we as a town don't do that, then we're missing out on a great opportunity.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.